friends, it's time for the Cranky Show!
We can clear the way to go down and watch the Cranky Show.
Cranky Show, Cranky Show.
Popcorn ready for the Cranky Show.
Cranky Show, Cranky Show.
When you've got no place to go.
Cranky Show.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Lab-RAT-ory. One of you asked about windshields and what to do with the windshields and how to work with the kit glass and all of that good stuff. And although this is not in any way a clinic, I wanted to get a discussion going. This is the way that the glass for the GTX comes in, or any kit for that matter. I mean, most manufacturers will bag the clear styrene. And so through the clear styrene, you often can gauge and see where you're at. Most of the time, nothing major will happen to the glass for the headlights or anything like that. But more often than not, even when your windshield comes wrapped like this, it'll withstand an imperfection or a scratch, or sometimes a what I would call a deadly flaw. So notice that this here, you could see it right there. Either it doesn't look like a scratch, but it looks like an imperfection in the glass itself. So what are you going to do? Well, you could have another kit and see if the glass is in better condition, or you can use a little bit of sanding with the sanding cloths, a little bit of Novus to fix it. And then maybe dip it in future clear and see if that'll resolve it. Or again, the way that we store a lot of the glass from the different kits. We rub parts from. We have a little spare glass thingy here. Now, if none of that helps, and you don't want to spend the money to buy another kit, then use clear acetate and cut it out in the shape of the glass and go with it. I mean, this is not a throwaway. Obviously, I'm going to come back over here, and I don't like it when both the rear and the front windshield are together like this, because that ruins your headliner effects, especially if you go out of your way to paint the headliner or detail the headliner. So normally I come in with my saw and I will save the rear glass. And then, of course, the front glass will have to figure out how to fix this. And again, several options, the last of which, of course, is just to cut new glass out of clear acetate. And that often works really well. Or you could, in fact, let me see if I can reach over here and show you the other possibility, which is, I believe, now that the glass is ruined, and I know that it's ruined for a fact, then, you go to your art supply place, and you get your hands on some very beautiful clear acetate like this. And so, there are some interesting possibilities here. You could go blue, you can go green, and again, you have to do the same treatment. You have to clean this up. And you have to make sure that these, of course, are casting a different. Here we go. That's much like it, much better. They have them in red as well, but the red tends to be a little bit pinkish. So I like orange, I like green, I like blue, And you know, so you cut your glass in the you know, you measure and you cut your glass more or less, and you make sure that you cut a nice clear unscratched piece, and you attach it. It's that simple. But I wouldn't, you know, I would say, you know, don't stress over the glass, because not all is lost. Not all is lost. And of course, you don't want to throw the glass out. You want to store it in whatever shape it's in, because if you build your model as a daily driver or a, you know, a junker, then you already have something to work with, you know. So anyway, this happens on a regular basis, and there's no need to stress over it. Just you know, do the best you can with your glass, and of course that includes application as well. Make sure you don't get glue on it, your hands are clean, blah blah blah. So you know, take care and do a good job on your glass. Your model will thank you for it. All right, my friends, stay tuned in for more Cranky Show.